Hello everyone. This video is an announcement of a series which will help not just the beginner backend engineers, but many of the senior backend engineers as well who are planning to get a touch base of the backend systems overall, and they want to get the overview of the backend engineering. So I was having conversation with multiple engineers in the recent past, especially in the last 1 month, and there were few concerns and few gaps which I understood that should be fulfilled. So I was having conversation with a few of them, and they said that, hey Anubhav, I know what these technologies are. Many of these technologies I have already learned in my college. And if not in college, in my company, in the first few years, I have learned them. But then there are other technologies as well, which are not very clear. For example, how do you work with Git, Postman, Jenkins, or CI/CD pipeline, or Redis? And then there are many advanced stuffs as well, like how do you deal with Azure or AWS? How do you create a logging pipeline? That is, how do you add log in your code and then get the logs in some dashboards or somewhere? And how do you integrate the payment system with your service? So there are multiple things overall. And how do you link everything together? How do these things get tied up together, and how do you think about it? So individual tutorials are available, but very few places these linking is done properly. So I thought, why not build a solution around this, and how do I present something which developers do in the real life? So let's take a real life example, and there we'll try to tie all of these things together so that you can learn along with me. Let me share a simple plan, and I think this will help us to not just build something but also learn. So the thing is, you can learn individual things independently, but here we'll try to knit them together, and while knitting them together, we'll just learn the things which are important. For example, if you go back to the previous page, if you start learning Java, it will never end. If you start learning databases, they will never end. But here my intent is not to teach Java in depth or databases in depth. What we'll do is that we'll pick a particular task, and then we'll learn only what is needed. In that way, we'll be able to cover the breadth, and we'll also be able to cover how these things are linked together. So the plan, if you see here, the first one, of course, is an overview. Then we'll do the local setup of Java Maven based project. There we'll use Spring Boot as well. Then we'll also talk about setting up a Git on local. Then we'll set up a CI/CD pipeline. That is, whenever you commit a code, our unit test and functional test will run, and your changes will be deployed to prod. Then we'll set up the database, that is, you know, the SQL database here. Then we'll have Git commands. So how do you commit your changes? How do you push your changes? How do you have a pull request? And then how do you add the PR or pull request command comments so that people can review and then approve it? Then we'll set up Postman so that we can test our backend APIs. We'll design a few REST APIs. And while designing the APIs, we'll talk how to think about the schema of the APIs, how various APIs work, and when to have what schema. So it's not just that we will have a random APIs here. We'll think through that what are the APIs we should have. And while doing so, we'll cover everything. We'll cover the low level, high level, everything while building the APIs, that how should the API look like? What's the schema? How would the JSON look like? So those things we'll talk here. Then we'll talk how to write a unit test and what are the principles which are followed while writing unit tests. So it's not that I'm just going to tell you the various tools for unit testing and various libraries, but there are important principles which one should follow while writing unit tests so that the unit tests are good enough and they don't intermittently fail. That's what we are going to talk. Then we'll set up some UI in the same Spring Boot project so that the front end code could also be written. We'll not have a separate UI because the project would initially be very small. So we'll just have one folder where we'll put all the HTML, CSS, JavaScript. So that will be the beginning project. And then once the project gets complex, then we'll have a separate repo. Then we'll have a login with Google, how to send the request IDs in headers. Then we'll integrate things with the database, logging, how to log things and how to have alerts so that if something goes down, you should have alerts. Then we'll build a bunch of features in the backend, and while building the features, we'll talk about various technologies and various low-level and high-level principles on deciding a particular solution. Then after that, we'll integrate things with the payment page, that now the customer has been able to add things to the cart. Now they should be able to integrate things to the payment so that they can make the payments. And then we'll have Redis as well, because for the session management, it's easier if you use some caching layer like Redis. We'll use that, and we'll talk about other solutions as well when we build the given solution. And then eventually we'll send mails and SMSs as well. Now, this is definitely not a comprehensive list to build website as big as Flipkart. And of course, we are not going to do that. We are going to have a very inferior version of Flipkart. That is something where you can have some catalog and you can do a bunch of activities. But of course, you can keep on building the features on this code base and you will keep on learning. So that's the idea, that we'll think about a feature gap and then we'll build on top of it. And while doing that, we'll consider various factors which a real-time engineer thinks through, and then they build a particular solution. So we'll think through all those factors and then build stuffs. So this is the overview which we are going to build. So this is the software development bootcamp course which we are going to have here. And there are a bunch of subcategories. For example, the concepts is, one is session management, the database, Azure SQL, DevOps will do using CI/CD pipeline, version control, Git and pull request. The front-end development will be plain HTML, CSS, JavaScript. You can of course go ahead with React and Redux, but I'll start simple and then I'll add complexity on top of the things. The crux here is that how do we tie all of these things together and keep things working? So that is more important. And while doing all of these things, keep the cost to the minimum. So we'll also have set up on Azure on cloud, and we'll see how to manage the cost. So that's what is also required. And we'll have some Java backend. So if you see here, I have set up an empty Windows machine where we'll set up everything from scratch. We'll install Java here. We'll install IntelliJ. We'll install various other things on this machine. And then we'll deploy everything on Azure. And when we deploy everything on Azure, we'll also keep track of the costing and various other important aspects which are important for the engineering. So yeah, that's the plan overall. And I hope this video was helpful. Please go through the mind map so that you understand what are the things I'm trying to tie together. And I hope this video was helpful. I hope that you look forward to the upcoming videos so that we all can learn together from each other. That's it from my side for this video. Till the next time. Bye.